This video will be in two parts. This is part one of displaying data in ADS. At the conclusion of this video, please continue with part two. This short video will focus on displaying data in ADS. I'll cover all the basics of using the data display window. I'll focus on data sets. Depending upon the type of simulation you're doing, the data set contents will be different. I'll cover how to plot and list data, how to use equations, and also some other information for using other types of data in ADS. Before we begin, I want to point out that the result of a successful ADS simulation is a data set, and it has a name. You can change the name. The default is the same as a schematic, and it's always written into the data folder of your project. And here in the main window of ADS, in the file view, you can see that there's a data folder, and if we expand it, then these data sets appear because this is the simulation data for this project. And here in the data display window, you can see all the available data sets, and those are the same ones that are in our ADS main window in the file view. So this is data.ds in the data directory. Looking at the project view, we see something different. We have DDS, that means this is a data display window, and you can see by the icon. So again, in the file view, you can see all the data sets, results of simulations. Here in the project view, you see the designs.dsn, and you see the data display windows that you create, .dds, and you can create multiple data display windows for any project. Now let's begin with the data display window. You can open it from the main window of ADS using this icon here. The data display window can also pop up automatically after a simulation. You can also open it from the schematic window, and the blank windows will appear untitled. Also, whenever you have a schematic and you run a simulation, then the name of the schematic, in this case DDS schematic, will also be the name of the data display, and it will automatically pop up. The data set will also have the same name. So by default in ADS, when you name a schematic, that name will be the same name for the data display and for your data set. However, you can control this by going to the schematic using the command simulate and then simulation setup, and I have it already hotkeyed for S, so I would just use that on my keyboard, hit S, and then I would get the simulation setup. And this is where you can name the data set, you can browse to existing data sets and overwrite them, or you can change to another data display if you have it by browsing to it. But as you can see, again, the default is the data set name and the data display window name are the same as the schematic. This checkbox here allows you to decide if you want the data display opened or not, and if you didn't, you'd simply use this icon here in schematic and you'd get a data display window open. Now for some basics about the data display window. The file command for opening and closing other windows, and save as template. When you use this, it brings up the dialog and you can type in the name for your data display, and then the data display is saved as a template, and you can always use it again by the insert template command. Now, the other important thing about the data display is that you can have multiple windows open, and you can open data displays from any project in ADS. Simply use this icon and browse to whatever you need. Then you can cut and paste between data displays. Look at the edit command for the cut, copy, and paste. Notice they're grayed out, but if I had something selected in the data display, they would be active. Also notice that the key binding or the hotkeys are available, and you can set up your own by going to Options, Hotkey Toolbar, and any hotkey can be set for any command in the data display window, and they only apply to the data display window and don't conflict with your schematic windows. Now those are a few basics about the window itself. Of course, there are many other commands here. Insert means you can insert lines, circles, rectangles, and text, and those are the same as the buttons here on the palette. Next is marker, and you can see the commands here. I have also hotkeyed M, which I prefer, so as soon as I use the M on my keyboard, I get a marker attached to the cursor. New peak valley, min max, and the delta mode and the next data point, those are the same as you see here. So these are the icons for these commands. And next we have history. Let me show you how that works. If we turn it on, notice what happens right here on the labeling of the traces. You'll see an H appear in parentheses, also an H right over here. That means history is on. So now if we go back to schematic, and in this case we'll just change the frequency for this simple circuit, just a circuit I'm using to demonstrate some of the capabilities. Let's change the frequency to 1.6 gigahertz and then we'll simulate again. And now here's the result. You can see we have our original trace and now we have a new trace. So we have the same data set name for both of these traces, and yet we have two separate traces. Now if we turn history off, watch what happens. We're going to get the last trace. And that's what you see here. Next we have the options command, and you've seen this hotkey already, which means you can decide which command you want a hotkey. For example, if I have M, then I simply go down here and select marker, and that'd be new marker. That's what I have. You don't have to worry about capitalization. It takes care of that for you. And this is for the toolbars, so you can control what tools or what menus that you want to see here, and that's all of this area here. Next we have the page command. You see one page here, it's called page one. Then I have another page that has another plot on it, all in the same data display window, and you can add pages. Simply use the command and it increments them, but you can give them a name, type it in, and then you get another page here, and you can use these tabs to go from one page to another. You can delete pages and change to each page right here. So that's how page works. The window command is very simple for opening and closing, and of course the help manuals. Finally, we'll get to tools later because it's mostly for the data file tool. That's the same button as this one here, and front panel for the jitter or eye diagrams. To conclude these basics, I'm going to use the view all command here, and notice that I have a list and several plots, and anytime you want to make some room, just use that zoom command, and now you have a blank area here. Of course, all of these lists and plots are now very large, and you can zoom in and out anytime you want, or again use view all. This is the refresh command. If you select a list, then these buttons become active. They're for scrolling through lists a line at a time or a page at a time. If you select a plot, then these buttons are used for zooming in to a specific area. So let's do that right now. We'll zoom in right into this area of the plot, and I'll also zoom into the plot itself. If I use the undo command, it returns it. Once again, notice if I zoom into an area of the plot, the axis values down here will change. And you can see that right there. And you can always go back. And that's how these buttons are used for individual plots, or for lists, these buttons here are used. Now that covers most of the commands and most of the toolbars. Next, let's look at what happens when you want to work with data in the data display. Please go to part 2, which is the second video of displaying data in ADS, and there I'll cover working with data, and also how to use other data in ADS.